And to heaven tonight. And I'd like us to just sing this song to worship the Lord. As we receive the word of God tonight. We give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. I believe the choir can help me.
Yes.
Glory to God. We just sing it a couple of times. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
We give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. We give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. Thank you tonight for the power of your word. We thank you for this praise night. We thank you because there is power in praises.
Yes.
And I ask tonight that every person under the sound of my voice will experience the mighty power in praise. I pray that the mighty power of the Holy Ghost will sweep across this auditorium.
Amen.
Thank you for the choir. Thank you for a fresh anointing upon them tonight as they minister. Blessed be your holy name.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Everyone shout aloud, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You may be seated.
Olejoko.
I'm going to be sharing briefly about the power of praise. The power of praise. I'd like you to understand, for those of you who are listening, I'd like us to understand that a Christian is not a disadvantaged species. A Christian is well equipped, well resourced, well enabled to live a victorious life in Christ. As a child of God, you are not limited. You are not disadvantaged. You are not weak. You are not poor. Because Jesus said, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. And you are part of that glorious church. You are part of that church that Jesus is building. And so the Bible said, whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. Because you are born of God, because you are a child of God, you are already an overcomer. Every overcomer here shout aloud,
hallelujah.
One of the equipment that God has given to us to live a victorious life, to defeat the enemy, is a six-letter word known as praise. Praise is not something we try. When things are not working, you know, sometimes you hear pastors say that if you have tried everything and it's not working, try praise. No. Praise is the natural habitat of every child of God. When you are a child of God, just as God said we should walk in love, you are supposed to walk in praise. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying tonight? Praise is supposed to be your lifestyle as a child of God. Praise is supposed to be your natural habitat as a child of God. The word of God tells us in Colossians 3:15. It said, let the peace of God rule in your heart. So which also you are called in one body. And be thankful. And in verse 16 it says, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. In all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. This is the will of God for you. As a New Testament believer, as a new creation in Christ, praise must flow from you. I'm praying for somebody tonight. Before you leave this place tonight, you are going to receive a fresh anointing of praise. Isaiah chapter 30. Isaiah chapter 30. And verse 29. There is a beautiful scripture there. So this is what the word of God said. He said, you shall have a song. You shall have a song. You shall have a song. Help me to tell somebody beside you, I said, you shall have a song. You shall have a song. Can you prophesy to someone that say, you shall have a song? He said, you shall have a song as in the night. As in the night. I'm glad about the God who gives us songs in the night. When the doctors don't know what to do, like the testimony we had today, when the doctors tell you there is no hope for you, that is the night season of life. But thank God, because God can give you a song in the night. The Bible said you shall have a song as in the night. When a holy solemnity is kept and gladness of heart, I mean Isaiah 30:29, and gladness of heart, as when one goes with a flute to come into the mountain of the Lord, to the mighty one of Israel. There is something that can bring you to the presence of God. It is called a song. I can't explain it. I don't understand it. But there's something about God and songs. God responds to singing. God responds to spiritual songs. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying tonight? When you begin to sing, it's like the Holy Ghost begins to tap his feet. When you begin to sing, it's like God begins to move. The Bible said, let God arise and let his enemies be scattered. But the way you can get God to arise is to praise him. When you praise him, you rouse him. And when he arises, his enemies are scattered. A lot of times people are concerned about scattering their enemies. But it's better to get God to arise. Because when he arises, then your enemy enemies are scattered. I see somebody's enemies scattered tonight in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible said you shall have a song as in the night. When you begin to sing and you begin to praise and you begin to worship God, something is going to happen. That's what we find in verse 30. The Bible said, and the Lord will cause his glorious voice to be heard. How many of you want to hear God's glorious voice? I believe you want to hear the voice of God. But there is something that can cause the glorious voice of God to be heard. And that is praise. That is praise. The Lord will cause his glorious voice to be heard. There is a voice that can lead you out of the wilderness. There is a voice that can give you a strategy. There is a voice that can defeat the enemy. There is a voice that can turn your breakdown to breakthrough. There is a voice that can show you what to do. I don't care what your situation is. I don't care what the situation in Nigeria is. It doesn't matter what the agenda of Islam is. There is a voice that will pull the church through. And that voice will come when you begin to praise God. When you begin to worship Him. When you begin to exalt Him. Is someone hearing what I'm saying tonight? The Lord will cause His glorious voice to be heard. Praising God, praising God positions you in a realm where you hear the voice of God expressly. Some of us are here tonight and you understand what I'm talking about. That at the moment when you are full of the joy of the Lord and you open your Bible to read, suddenly God is speaking to you. Suddenly God is talking to you. Suddenly you have inspiration. You know the reason why? Because there is something about joy and about praise. There is something about praising God that turns on the light, that brings down the presence and the glory of God. The word of God tells us something. Ephesians chapter 5 verse 18 and 19. He said, and be not drunk with wine wherein is excess, but be filled with the Spirit, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. He said, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. Let me tell you something, brethren. Many of you are not unfamiliar with the power of praise. You are not unfamiliar with it. But how can you praise God when the light is out? How can you praise God when you are going through trying times? How can you praise God when your child is sick and there's no money in your pocket and you don't know where your next meal will come from? How did Paul and Silas praise God in a Philippian jail? How can Paul write in Philippians chapter 4 verse 4, rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice? He was writing it when he was in jail. How is it possible to do that? You can never praise God like that without the Holy Ghost. There is a spirit of singing. There is a spirit of joy that can come upon your life and baptize you and fill you up. And when that spirit comes upon you, singing will become spontaneous. Dancing will become automatic. Terrible things happening all around. And a lot of people are suffering from depression. They are suffering from depression. They are depressed. They are not happy. People are sad. They are full of sorrow. And it's understandable. Because when you look at things naturally, the normal response is to be sad and sorrowful. But are you not glad that we are not natural people? We are not from here, we are from above. We have the life of God in us. We live by the atmosphere of heaven. There is an anointing that can come on your life. It is called the oil of joy. In Isaiah 61 verse 3, he said to give the oil of joy instead of mourning, and the garment of praise instead of the spirit of heaviness. I speak tonight by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Anyone who is under the influence of the spirit of heaviness, as you said this believing amen, may you be released now in the name of Jesus Christ. God wants you to have the oil of joy. That is what is also known as the spirit of praise. That is the spirit of singing. That is the spirit of melody. That is what turns you on in the middle of the night. That is what makes you to praise God in spite of circumstances and situations. That oil of joy is the dimension of the Holy Ghost that many children of God are not aware of. Christianity and depression don't go together. Christianity and depression don't go together. Christianity and sorrow don't go together. Yes, you can have sorrowful circumstances, but you can refuse to respond to sorrow. John was on the Isle of Patmos. He was surrounded by destitution. Destitution. He was surrounded by hopelessness. But he said, on the Lord's day, I heard a voice behind me. It was a voice of singing. It was a voice of rejoicing. It was a voice of glory. It was a voice coming from the other realm. Oh, I pray tonight that the Holy Ghost will open you up to the other realm. Things can be down on this side. Things can be down on this side. But there is a side where there is constant rejoicing. You may not have money on this side, but there is a side where there is jubilation. Everything can be down on this side, but there is a realm. There is a place where there is constant rejoicing. Where Jesus pours the oil of joy on your head. Tonight, if you will hear the voice of God, if your Assyrians will be beaten down, if your night will be turned today, you need to begin to praise God habitually. But in order to praise God consistently, you need the oil of joy. Let me round up by telling you this statement. When you are joyful, you will be praiseful. And when you are praiseful, You will be Godful. Because God inhabits the praises of his people. God indwells the praises of his people. And when you are Godful, you will be wonderful. I want you to rise on your feet tonight. God wants to release the oil of joy. Because that is what you need. The Bible said the joy of the Lord shall be your strength. The joy of the Lord shall be your strength. You don't need to be weak. You don't need to be down. You don't need to be depressed. When the joy of the Lord is there, that joy translates into strength. I want you to lift your two hands to heaven tonight. I'm going to ask you first of all to open your mouth. Open your mouth and sing any song unto God. Any song of your choice. Just open your mouth and sing any song. Sing any song of your choice unto God. Open your mouth, appreciate him. Exalt him, glorify him. Open your mouth, give him praise. Give him glory, open your mouth. Bless him. Thank him. Sing a song unto him. Any song of praise unto him. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Bless the Lord. Bless him. Appreciate him. Thank him. For he's a glorious God. He's awesome. He's marvelous. He's a wonderful God. He's the King of glory. He's the I am that I am. Appreciate him tonight. Come on, appreciate him tonight. Open your mouth and give him praise. Open your mouth and give him glory. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Just one more minute. Come on, sing a song unto God. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Amen.
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 Now tonight, I want you to open up and receive the oil of joy. There is an anointing of joy. It's different from when you are happy. When something good happens to you, you are happy. But when the joy of the Lord is on your head, according to Isaiah 51 verse 11, which says, the redeemed of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be on their head. He said they shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. That spirit of joy is coming upon somebody tonight. Let me tell you something. It doesn't matter what is happening in Nigeria. The joy of the Lord on your head will pull you through. Will cause you to hear a voice from heaven that will give you direction. The Bible said your ears will hear a word behind you saying, this is the way, this is the way. This is the way, this is the way. Tonight, you are going to pray. 1 minute. Lord, I receive the anointing of joy. Every spirit spirit of sorrow, every spirit of grief, the Lord told me that there is someone here who has the spirit of grief and sorrow. And the Lord said that spirit came into you when you lost a child. You lost a child. It looks to me like it was a son that you lost. You lost a child. Now tonight, as we pray, now that spirit has been with you for a long time, but that spirit is going to get out of you tonight, because you are going to receive the joy of the Lord. Some of you, when you leave this place tonight, you won't know whether you walked home or you floated in the air, because you'll be so full of joy. I'm going to ask you right now, lift your right hand to heaven. Say, Father. Say, Father. Tonight, I receive the anointing of joy, the oil of joy. I reject the spirit of sorrow, the spirit of grief, the spirit of depression, in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth. Come on. Open your mouth. Receive the oil of joy. 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 Open your mouth and receive right now. They shall obtain. They shall obtain joy and gladness. Tonight, obtain the joy of the Lord. Receive the garment of praise. Command sorrow to get out of your house. Get out of my family. Get out of me. Spirit of sorrow and depression. Get out in the name of Jesus. Get out in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
In medicine, there are some sicknesses that are known as psychosomatic illnesses. Now, these sicknesses are as a result of a depressed state of mind. You know, medical science is following the Bible. Because it's written in the Bible a long time ago that a merry heart doeth good like medicine, but a broken spirit dries the bone. Tonight, everyone whose heart is broken, everyone whose spirit is broken, by the anointing of joy, by the spirit of the Lord, receive your healing in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree tonight, let the oil of joy flow upon this congregation. Receive the oil of joy in the name of Jesus. Receive the anointing of joy in the name of Jesus. Now there's something that you're going to do right now. Everyone here who is under the influence of the spirit of heaviness and sorrow and grief, where you are going to do something. I'm going to ask you to take a deep breath in and out 3 times. You are going to do that. Wait for me. Don't do it yet. You are going to take a deep breath in 3 times and out. As you take the last breath out, that spirit that has been with you and it's causing depression in your heart and it's affecting your body, affecting your health, that spirit will get out in the name of Jesus Christ. When I give you a count and I say 1, 2, 3, go, you take a deep breath in and out 3 times. And then I'm going to pray for you. Father, I thank you because the power is here. and thank you because the oil of joy is here. Thank you for the atmosphere of heaven that is here tonight. I pray that every one of your children who is under the bondage and the influence of the spirit of depression and grief and sorrow, we speak that this is their moment of deliverance. And this is their moment of release.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When I say 1, 2, 3, you take a deep breath in 3 times and out. And then I'll pray. 1, 2, 3. Take a deep breath in and out 3 times. Do it a second time. Do it a third time. Yes. Father, thank you. Thank you for that release. Thank you for that release.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for that release.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for that release.
Thank you, Lord.
As you took that deep breath the third time, some of you felt a heaviness left you. Every heaviness that has left you will never come back again. From tonight, the same anointing that was upon Paul and Silas that made them to praise God while they were in chains. As you say this, believing amen, in faith, let that same anointing come on your head in the name of Jesus
amen.
Christ. As you begin to praise God from tonight, may your ears be open to hear the voice of God.
Amen.
And by the voice of God, may the cedars of Lebanon in your life be broken to pieces.
Amen.
May the flames of fire in your life be divided.
Amen.
By the voice of God, may your wilderness be turned to a fruitful
yeah.
field. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we give you praise.
Thank you, Father.
We give you glory.
Yes, Lord.
We give you honor.
Yes, Lord.
Blessed be your name, O God.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Now, you are going to shout a powerful, mighty hallelujah in this room. By the shout of hallelujah, the walls of Jericho came down. You are going to shout a mighty hallelujah and this building will shake. Are you ready for that? I said, are you ready for that? Open your mouth and shout a loud hallelujah.
Hallelujah.